Obama's on this vacation. I was just thinking, his life is 100 million times better right now than living in the White House.
Of course.
Of course it is.
It's the worst job ever.
It's so much better. Like,
the worst job ever.
Did you watch any of the interview with President Trump and Bill O'Reilly?
No.
So Trump was...
Are you serious?
So,
no, no, well...
I don't
just
care about that stuff.
By comparison, again, not about the issues, but Trump was talking about his life now.
How it ruined his life?
And
worst job ever.
And there was an article in the New York Times about his life, like when he wakes up, when he goes to bed, and all this sort of stuff. And what he told Bill O'Reilly was that he's going to bed like 11 or 12, and he's getting up like at 5 a.m., and the article in the Times,
dead.
the article in the New York Times said, you know, well, his wife's living in New York, so he's his son-in-law Jared Kushner, who's one of his advisors, apparently he's already gotten kind of into the social scene, and he's kind of like out and about in Washington. He's got his wife, he's got his family, so he's kind of like flying solo there at times, and meanwhile, President Obama's kite surfing.
Of course. His life is so much better than
it's
not being
so
in the White
much
House.
Better.
He basically did, Obama basically did 8 years of hard labor.
Right.
Yeah. That's what he did. So like, he should be able to enjoy
himself. Talked about it before. Who would want that job?
I don't know.
Not me. I wouldn't even want to be the governor, although when we hung out with the governor.
I wouldn't want to be a mayor of a town of 100.
No, it's too much responsibility. But I will say this. When we hung out with Ehrlich when he was the governor of Maryland for about 4 years, and periodically, you know, a few times we went over to the mansion, whatever, play golf with him, whatever. That's a pretty nice life, though.
Got some nice perks.
You get some nice perks. Now, that's not like being the president.
Right.
You know, so you still have to deal with some stuff. You got to make sure nobody's going to blow up one of the tunnels.
Right.
Or anything.
Right.
But, you have to walk over to the state house and bang a gavel and do whatever you do.
But generally speaking, you go into your silly mansion and you have 100 people waiting on you and you're making silly dinners and you get driven around. We were driven around with the governor's cavalcade of SUVs when we went to the Preakness one time.
I'll never forget that.
They're going 100 miles an hour,
right.
Bumper to bumper to bumper to bumper, with police escorts. It is the way to live.
That was on the Beltway.
It's unbelievable.
Then when we got into Baltimore City, they're basically driving down the wrong side of the road.
They shut down all the roads.
Shut down roads
they
for part the governor.
The sea for you.
Felt kind of silly.
And then we went to a Ravens game with the governor. Everyone's hollering at you.
Right.
You're king of the world.
All right, that part's fine.
That's the great part. Governor, okay. I think, is where you want to top out.
I know, but the meetings.
Yes.
Are you serious?
Hanging out.
I mean, just the everlasting number of meetings you have.
I would never in a million years.
Policy? You have to make policy?
I would never want to be president, but I could see being governor. I think governor is the perfect. That's the perfect
spot. I can't see Trumpy wanting to be president after his first term. I think he's going to say, bump this. I didn't even want the job anyway. I didn't think I had a prayer
Never
winning.
Never expected to win.
There's no chance I'm doing 4 more years of this. Plus, he's going to be like 75.
I think if he goes 8 years, he'll be 78.
Yeah, it'd be 78.
Yeah, I'm saying, but the second term would start when he's about 75.
Right.
There's just no way. He could be the greatest president in history. He is out
he
after 4 years.
So much
better.
He did
so much better to vacation.
He did a weekend though at his spot in Florida. He might just start doing weekends there all the time.
If I were him,
he's gonna realize he's gonna have to park.
I would never leave Mar-a-Lago. Ever.
Yeah.
I would just look around and say, "Why would I leave this tropical paradise? I'm never leaving."
But I still look at those pictures. President Obama couldn't have looked happier.
He looks a lot younger, too.
Yeah, he's going to get...
He's kite surfing. He looks good.
You watch.
Yeah.
Well, just the stress.
It's the worst job ever. Yeah. I don't know why anybody would want to be involved
in
it.
You were wrong.
And then even... For some reason, I was just thinking about, like, these dumb senators that have to, like, filibuster.
That's
Can you imagine if your kid had a game and you had to miss your kid's game because you had to filibuster some dumb bill?
You just have to keep talking.
I literally want to blow my brains out. I got to go up there and read Dr. Seuss for 28 hours.
Most of them.
Miss all my kids' games.
I'll say
miss my life.
Most of them don't have kids' games. Most of them are old.
I was thinking of like Paul Ryan or somebody.
Okay,
you know?
Yeah.
There are guys that are young.
Right,
Obama's kids aren't.
Yeah.
Right.
You
but
imagine?
I'm saying a lot.
I mean, he's got a sophomore in high school.
Sorry, kid. I can't go to your volleyball game. I got to go filibuster.
I mean, I think we live in a great country. And
so
but the fact that somebody can just get up and just for like 30 straight hours just to delay something that's probably going to happen anyway.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
So stupid.
Our country's dumb.
It's
so stupid.
At least we're not as stupid as other countries. Do they still put on those wigs for the Wig Party
in
England?
They might do that.
I
think they do.
They have those debates.
I don't know.
I think Kristen Wiig's kind of cute.
Kristen Wiig? Yeah.
I don't understand Tories and Whigs. I don't get all that.
It's pretty rowdy over there. Like, even when they're big silly, their prime minister or president, whatever it's called over there, even when they're addressing the donks.
They're not respectful.
They have zero respect.
Powdered wigs are stupid. I mean, you know where you see a lot of powdered wigs? Williamsburg. If you like going and see the way people lived in the 1700s, go to Williamsburg, Virginia. Pretty fun.
Anyway, if you want to see the pictures, we'll put it up on the Junkies Facebook page.
He definitely looks a lot happier.
You can go to facebook.com.
Frolicking around with a billionaire.
Is he one of the younger ex-presidents, like when his term ended? Like, how old was Slick Willie when his term ended? He was older, right?
I think so.
And W, I think, was older. He's got to be one of the younger. Well, I mean, just look it up. Is he one of the younger presidents?
Yeah. Well, Kennedy would be assassinated, right?
He's got to be one of the top five younger ones.
And Trump's the oldest.
Well,
I don't know if he's the oldest.
Reagan was pretty old.
Yeah, Reagan was
I think Trump was the oldest